Well, Andrew, this is being called the perfect storm. Over the past 20 years, there's been a huge rise in prescription medications, people using the pills to get high, and then they switch to heroin because initially heroin is a fraction of the cost. But Allegheny County officials are now saying we have a problem, and the numbers with this don't lie. You've seen the news stories.
Suspected heroin dealer busted.
Son was a heroin addict and
100 empty stamp bags of heroin.
But behind most heroin arrests is a disease. This is the new face of heroin addiction. Young adults, well-educated, driven. Meet 25-year-old Jeremy Brinkley of Moon Township. He overdosed this April.
He wasn't raised in the inner city. He's not black or Hispanic. He didn't grow up in poverty. But he was an addict.
Jeremy was in and out of rehab. His dad went to pick him up one night to take his son to a new facility for treatment. But Stuart Brinkley instead walked into his deepest fear.
And I was pretty sure what I was going to find. And that was him stiff and cold on the floor.
Jeremy overdosed on 22 bags of heroin. The drug has punched its way into Pittsburgh's surrounding suburbs. Dr. Neil Capretto with Gateway Rehabilitation Center says right now, more heroin is being used in Western PA than any other time in history.
It's no longer what people used to refer to as the inner city drug.
It is everywhere. It's very much become a middle, even upper middle class substance. In Allegheny County, we set a record last year, 261 drug overdose deaths. That's more than traffic fatalities and homicides put together.
According to the Allegheny County Health Department, drug overdose deaths in the past 10 years have tripled among county residents 24 years old and younger.
This is the medication we carry now of the Narcan.
Paramedic Eric Poach with Monroeville EMS says first responders are on the front lines of combating heroin overdoses. They use a drug called Narcan to block the effects of the opiate, but the demand for it has dramatically increased.
The heroin we see now, probably from Central Asia, way stronger than what we used to see. Like I said, it takes 10 to 20 times the amount of medication to reverse the heroin effects in the overdose.
Because I believe that there is a stereotype, especially in the suburbs, and more importantly in the more affluent suburbs, that heroin is not a problem in their neighborhood, in their school district, in their community.
Battling addiction is so complex. The disease does not discriminate in race, sex, or economic status. And in essence, that's Jeremy's story, a story becoming all too familiar in Allegheny County.
My goal is to try to save one other family from going through what we went through.
And if that... It's a powerful message, but
right.
Dr. Capretto was also telling me that back in 1969 and 1970, heroin was 10% pure. Now it's 70 to 90% pure. So that's why the addiction is so much more powerful from the get-go.
And you've always heard, you try it once, you're hooked, and that people even try it, and that they're trying it in these numbers, and that this is happening, it takes your breath away.
Exactly. So education here is the best prevention. So they're saying parents, talk to your kids, have an open discussion, and get the word out.
And we've educated a lot of people tonight, letting them know it's not just a city problem anymore.
Yes, hopefully.
Kelly. Good stuff, Kelly.
Thank you.